everyone, and welcome to the Premium Video Newsletter for Thursday, September 26th. It's finally Thursday, and this is when the markets get interesting due to all the releases from the Feds. So let's get right into it and start with the fundamentals. Pressure is building over legislation to prevent a partial government shutdown. Traders are currently focusing more on the budget showdown in Washington and a little less on when the Federal Reserve will scale back their quantitative easing program. There's a possibility of a government shutdown and potentially even a debt default if an agreement is not reached. If this happens, it will have a huge impact on the economy and certainly the stock market. Congress must reach a budget deal by Monday in order for the government to continue to pay its bills. The fundamentals that we saw this morning were offsetting to a little weaker than anticipated. The second quarter annualized gross domestic product, or GDP, increased 2.5% when at 2.6% was anticipated, and personal consumption was up 1.8%, which compares to an estimate of 1.9%. Jobless claims in the week ending September 21st declined 5,000 to 305,000. This compares to an estimate of 325,000. The government, especially the Feds, is watching this number very carefully. Fewer Americans signed contracts to buy U.S. homes in August, the third straight decline in a row. The drop could mean that higher mortgage rates are starting to deter buyers. Stocks once again open higher and appear to be losing steam. This has become a pattern over the last few days as each day we open higher and drift lower. This is a very strong characteristic of a bearish market cycle, and I want to warn you of that. In a bull market, stocks typically open lower and trade higher as the day continues, and with a bearish market, we're seeing the opposite. In addition, we're seeing an island reversal pattern. I'm sure by now you're familiar with this pattern because we saw it in crude and gold very recently, and now we're seeing in the broad market just as well. Before we get too bearish on the overall market, I want to point out that a few indexes that are my guides are actually performing much stronger than the broad market, unusually so, to be honest with you. Therefore, I'm not anticipating a major sell-off at this time. I'm only looking to see what the next market swing will hold for us. This is why I want to alert you to the Russell. As you know, the Russell and transports are my two guides when I'm having difficulty determining market direction. And right now, the Russell is still showing me remarkable strength in light of what we're seeing in the S&P, or the broad market, as I like to call it. On one hand, we have fairly strong divergence between the RSI and market price. But on the other hand, we are ticks away from an all-time high, and the market is doing a remarkable job maintaining strength in light of the broad market. This is a speculative index and has less interest rates impact than the big market, but nonetheless, the Russell is giving me pause about a major drop in the broad market. So I'm not looking for much upside right now, but I'm also limiting my downside as well. What's interesting is our setups are confirming this just as well. Because when markets get choppy, the number of setups decrease, and this has been happening all week long. The bond market had a first down day after four stronger closes. The RSI is not greatly overbought, but it's letting us know that the market is getting towards overbought levels. This is also reflected in the price because an inside day generally signals a pause in the current move. The bond market is going lower, but we don't have certainty from the Feds just yet. The fundamentals this morning were not strong or weak enough to really do anything, and what we need now is a few choppy days. So buyers who got in a few days ago begin to panic. This generally happens a few days after a strong move. If you're long the bond market, I recommend you tighten your position and possibly reduce it as well, because the upside is limited at this time. Remember what I say about this market, it's very choppy, so don't expect a parabolic or a straight up move anytime soon. I promised you that I would follow the Aussie during the last few days, and today we're seeing a tightening of the bearish triangle pattern that's been building during the last week and a half. Remember, the long-term trend is down, and bearish triangle is a continuation pattern. The best type of breakdowns from a bearish triangle occur with strong momentum and gaps. If you start seeing a small break, be very cautious. We want to see an all-out move that shows strong selling pressure. Many times, traders see small violations and think that's a break. That's the floor traders picking your stop orders and nothing more. You want to see a move that has commitment to it, and unless you see something similar to what I'm describing, we may continue tightening the triangle for the next few days, especially since there's not much data till middle of next week on the horizon. I'd like to look at the crude market since we've been ignoring it for a few days now. We had a symmetrical triangle, and I gave you my analysis a few weeks back, how we're very dependent on Syria. If we attacked, we would have broken upwards, and we didn't, and we broke downwards. I also remember explaining that the triangle is a continuation pattern, and the trend is still up. Syria didn't pan out, and we clearly turned south, but we're still technically holding on to the last leg of an uptrend. If we violate the current levels, we will start moving down below the 101 level. Fund managers who trade commodities don't rely on the 50-day moving average as much as they do when they trade stocks. And this is why I'm not focusing on it right now. We do have some fundamental evidence of higher global demand, and this is the only thing keeping me from selling at these levels. Wait for a drop below the 101 level. If we move down below that level, there will be plenty of time to get in on the downside. Let's take a look at the setups for tomorrow. We actually have a long setup on QQQ, which is the NASDAQ 100. I analyzed this index yesterday, and as I mentioned, the upside is limited right now. I think the stock market is going to weaken in the next few weeks and may trade slightly lower, so be cautious when you're taking long trades right now. If you do go long, enter 20 cents above today's high, and if filled, place a sell stop 20 cents below today's low. That's it for today's tutorial. I will touch base with you tomorrow midday as usual. Tomorrow we have personal income and expense report, and unless something very surprising happens, we should have a calm Friday. Have a great night, everyone.